Hello everyone, this is Joe at the National Weather Service at Billings. Let's take a look at what to expect for the upcoming winter. I'll also discuss our winter climatology. First, here is the official December, January, February outlook from the Climate Prediction Center, most recently issued on October 20th. As you can see, our region is highlighted for a hedging toward above normal precipitation with a very slight lean toward below normal temperatures, especially in northeast Montana. This is quite a bit different than last year. So, what is behind this outlook? We are expecting the development of a weak La Nina in the tropical Pacific Ocean for the late fall and winter. La Nina is the cool phase of the El Nino Southern Oscillation, or ENSO, and it causes a shift in weather tendencies around the globe. For our purposes, cooler than normal water in the eastern equatorial Pacific typically results in an enhanced polar jet. This can result in cooler and wetter conditions from the Pacific Northwest to the Northern Plains. However, these tendencies are more pronounced during a moderate or strong La Nina, which this will not be. Also, La Ninas tend to be windier on the east side of the Rockies, and we will be prone to experience periods of warm and windy weather. Of course, La Nina is just one piece of the puzzle. Arctic sea ice, which is well below normal, wind, snow cover, and luck, yes, luck, all play a role in determining the fate of our winter, making seasonal predictions very challenging. Overall, given that sea surface temperatures have cooled in the eastern tropical Pacific, as well as across much of the northeast Pacific Ocean, this winter should be cooler and wetter than last season. Keep in mind that these outlooks are based on averages over an entire season. In reality, we see periods of warm, dry weather and cool, wet conditions during the course of all winters. That is, a cool outlook does not mean we won't have periods of warmth too, and vice versa. A perfect example of these winter extremes is during our very snowy 2013-14 winter, during which Billings received a record 103.5 inches of snowfall. How many of you remember that January? It was actually quite mild, with an average temperature of over 3 degrees above normal, and 7 days with high temps of at least 50 degrees. Also, we had little or no snow on the ground for a good portion of the month. So, although it was a cold and record snowy winter for Billings overall, there was an extended period of very mild weather in January. I also wanted to point out that it is impossible to predict the weather on a specific date more than a few days or maybe a week in advance, especially in the winter when weather patterns can change quickly and dramatically. For example, let's say you were wondering what it was going to be like on Christmas Day. The answer is, right now, we don't know. But we can say a lot about the climatology of Christmas, and that's what's important for you to know. As an example, here is a plot of high temperatures observed at the Billings Airport since 1934. That's a lot of variability. The average high is 35, but we've seen highs range from minus 6 in 1996 to 56 in 2005. The actual high temperature was exactly 35 degrees only once in 82 years, and in fact, it was within 5 degrees of normal only 32% of the time. So when thinking about Christmas or any other day during the winter, understand that there is a wide range of possibilities, and this is a trademark of our region's climatology during the winter. Why the crazy extremes during the winter season? We really do live in a unique location along the high plains. To our north, there is nothing to stop cold Canadian air masses from sliding down the east slopes of the Rockies and into our area. At the same time, we are prone to see strong downslope winds develop off the mountains, and this causes warm and dry spells during the middle of winter. Think of the differences between Missoula and Billings. Missoula is west of the mountains and does not experience rapid temperature changes, but a lot of fog and low clouds. Billings is east of the mountains and sees some remarkable temperature changes and plenty of wind. Always anticipate the extremes in our region during the winter. On the east side of the mountains, average is not something that occurs very often. That's all I have, folks. I hope you're excited as me that winter is nearly upon us, and thanks for watching this video. Feel free to call us or chat through social media anytime. Have a good day and a good winter.